A press release issued by the Royal St. Lucia Police Force on Friday reads, on Friday, October 7, 2022, officers attached to the Major Crime Unit spearheaded an operation at Leclerc Castries, where a suspect was apprehended. Consequently, Stanley Felix of Leclerc Castries was formally charged with the offence of perverting the course of justice, contrary to Section 376 of the Criminal Code of St. Lucia. He was escorted before the First District Court, where he was granted bail in the sum of $15,000, cash or suitable surety. He was also assigned reporting conditions and travel restrictions. Felix was also St. Lucia's Senate President, and with news surrounding his arrest and subsequent charge, St. Lucians have called on Prime Minister Philippe J. Pierre to relieve Mr. Felix of his post. Prime Minister Pierre provided an update to the media Monday.
Stanley Felix is on bail and he's dealing with his defense. In our law says you're innocent until proven guilty. He's at home.
So how come he was fired if he's innocent until proven
no,
guilty?
No, because you know we've said that we give him time to see about his legal matters.
Prime Minister Pierre, however, did not indicate who would be the new Senate President. The United Workers Party, in a recent press release on the matter, stated, quote, the United Workers Party sees this as another dark day in the history of St. Lucia, when the country is already battered by an increase in serious crime, particularly robberies and gun-related homicides, end quote. Deputy Prime Minister Dr. Odette Hilaire has applauded Prime Minister Philippe J.P.'s handling of the matter, calling it a good show of governance.
There are times when you have to deal with challenges, and you deal with them in a very decisive way, and that's what the Prime Minister showed, that he is decisive and he sticks to the principles that he promised the people of St. Lucia. I think, you know, the Prime Minister will do what has to be done to ensure that we are adequately represented in the Senate. And, you know, we're going to continue to do the hard work that we've been doing, to focus on putting the people first. And, you know, when you're in government, those situations come up from time to time, not exactly this, but you have to deal with situations and you have to be decisive, you have to be consistent with what you promise the people, and you have to let the courts decide where they have to decide.
As St. Lucians await the appointment of a new Senate President, the Upper House is scheduled to convene Thursday, 13 October. For the DBS News World, Lisa Joseph reporting.